Okay, some of these are questions that we are answering, are asking in our own minds.
Thank you.
Thank you. So, gentlemen, I need a vote to close the public hearing portion.
Mr. Chairman?
Yes.
Could I pose just two questions to you?
Sure.
The first question would be a traffic question. And I'd like to know if the traffic expert has an estimate of the number of additional truck accidents that would occur if the plant were permitted.
Thank you. In one of the responses to the town questions, we did estimates of crash predictions, and we did it on two levels. First, in terms of the number of crashes that we'd see increased, and then secondly, in terms of hazmat. When we calculated out the number of crashes we'd expect to increase based on this project, it came out to be, during operation of the project, to be one additional accident in a three-year period. To relate that to truck traffic, the roadways that we're evaluating have less than 10% truck traffic.
Ladies and gentlemen, remember, this is what they estimated. She's giving you information. Whether you believe it or not, is not the question. Please continue.
So if we were to convert that rate into a truck rate, again, using the fact that those roads have less than 10% truck traffic, we'd be looking at one-tenth of that rate in terms of trucks. So instead of one accident every 3 years, it would probably be one truck accident every 10 years.
Mr. Chairman, I have just one more question.
Yes,
would like the benefit to answer it for us in writing, please, because I think that's the only logical way to do this. But if I could pose this to Council for Invenergy, the experts for the town have prepared a number of reports, all of which I believe have been furnished to you. And in each of those reports, whether they deal with the air, the noise, the ammonia, the traffic, the MTBE, the water, the sewer, or the master plan, the town experts have all made a number of recommendations. And what I would like to have answered in writing is which of those recommendations Invenergy is committed to complying with, and which of those Invenergy is not prepared to comply with, and if so, if they're not prepared to comply with it, why, for each one of those.
Excellent suggestion, sir.
Thank you. And as a subpart of that, I'd like to ask Invenergy to do the same thing for the recent DOH report that is also filled with a number of recommendations from DOH. Again, please answer, will you comply with each of those? And for those you will not comply with, why? Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, so looking for a motion to close the public hearing. I have a motion.
Do I have a second?
I have a second. Any discussion?
Are we closing the public hearing or just a public comment period of this hearing?
The public hearing.
Aren't we continuing it to another night? I'm talking about notice provisions for the public hearing.
Okay.
Mr. Chairman, I believe there's one more witness regarding water that Invenergy needs to produce.
Oh, I'm sorry. You are correct. I'm sorry. Okay. So it is a public comment. Okay. So thank you. Did I second on that? Okay. So is our public comment period?
Which part of this discussion? Which one was that?
All those in favor?
Aye.
And opposed?
Sorry.
Okay. Tom, any final thoughts?
The one question I had that I wrote down was, it's probably a question for Tom Hebner. In light of the URI study that was done that did the model, the pump testing there for a time, do we know, and this is something for you to think about, Tom, not in my answer tonight, but what would be an acceptable amount of time to pump those wells, in effect, to confirm the modeling that would need to be done? You know, like, do we do the worst case scenario? Do we pump 925,000 gallons per day for 30 days and see how the aquifer performs? You know, that's kind of my one question I got from tonight. I think Mike brings up a good point about getting the applicant to confirm what they're going to comply with. We really can't meet until you have that, I would think, right? Because then you're going to want to base your advisory on what the commitments would
be. Correct, correct. Because our experts, if you will, have made these recommendations, and obviously our opinion would be picked up by that.
So. And so this is where I'm going with that. I have some of the audience here still thinking in the future of a date certain here. When do we meet next? You know, what's an acceptable time commitment to have that applicant give us that data? I also want my own accounts consultants to think about, you know, tomorrow or the next day at the latest, I'm going to get them all the written testimony.
Yep.
I'd like to have our consultants go through that, you know, and give us any new advice or recommendations based on what we've heard from the public. So.
Right.
There's two things there. They're going to take time. I want to get that information. Then we get a meeting in. So I don't know what that date should be. We have the meeting the first Monday in August. But
right.
I got to separate these.
I'm sure there will be a second one in August.
It's going to have to be.
Yeah.
Because I'm trying to separate out the regular agenda from this stuff. But
yeah.
And maybe we bank on first and second Monday in August. Because Mondays tend to work.
Yep.
For you guys.
Our regular meeting on the 8th. This one on the 1st, a regular meeting on the 8th, and I'm assuming it will be the 16th.
So maybe we're going to the 3rd,
the
1st and 3rd Monday then in August, right?
Yep.
Maybe?
Yep.
Is that what it is, 1st and 15th?
Yep. Okay. But in any event, the 1st will be back.
First will be for our regular meeting. Developer to see if I'm right. We're thinking the 15th. Want to say the 15th then for this for Invenergy?
Okay.
So what's going to happen on the 1st?
The 1st is a regular planning board meeting that doesn't involve you guys.
Right.
So we're just going to
15th. I'm sorry, I'm thinking out loud here.
And why don't we set the 22nd as a tentative one also if we need it? If we need it. I know, I could do it fast. Oh, I get it. Okay.
Do you want to do 6 p.m. again or 7?
Yes.
6 p.m.? 6
is good. 6 is good.
Okay.
Let's do that. Do we need a motion to continue the public?
Certainly.
Okay.
Yep.
All right. So let's do that. So, motion from the chair to continue this meeting until the 15th of August at 6 o'clock here. And I have a second. Any discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Okay.
I would like to get Invenergy at least a week prior to that day because I got to put this package together with Chris
right.
And deliver it to you guys. So at least a full week before that.
Yep. Okay.
Could I ask a question, a quick question? Has the town of Douglas and the state of Massachusetts, which is only 2 miles from this plant or less, approved all this and had all the materials?
Not to my knowledge, nor are they.
We require to notify them, and we notify them of the meeting. But I don't know what they have done as far as having their own meeting.
Yes, yeah, so they may want them. My understanding is their concern.
Okay, we tabled them already. Why don't we do it next time? All right, anyone else? Tom, you all set?
Yes.
Okay. I have a motion to adjourn. And a second.
Just a question. Are the town's experts being required to attend
the other? No, from the same, at the end of the same. So we have a motion to adjourn. All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Very good. Thank you.